Well, good morning, good morning, good morning. It's Sunday, and it's a rare Sunday stream from me, Slow Psycho. How are you? Hope you are having a nice, calm, and gentle, relaxing morning as you realise that you're now an hour out from everybody else. I hope you made sure that you sprung forward your clocks, as it is now 10 a.m. Yeah, it was 9 a.m, wasn't it? And this is where we left each other yesterday, if you were with us. This is our sunset in vanilla. As you can see, got a fire going on there, that's fine, they'll sort that. There's the fire engines, look. Fire engines are coming, it's fine. Oh, what we got there? What's full? Cemetery. No more room. Well, unfortunately then, you're going to be closed, aren't you? We haven't got a crematorium yet, you see. If you're continuing to... Ooh, what's going on here? Not enough workers. Right, we need more people then. Obviously, we need more people to live. And the plan today is to develop this a bit more. Maybe put in a bit less structured, a bit more free-flowing. Maybe here, maybe here, maybe up here. Maybe. Maybe. Possibly. We don't generally have a plan with this sort of game here on Slow Psycho. We go as the free flows. Not enough educated workers. They need some well-educated workers, and they've actually got some uneducated workers, which is fine. Let's have a look at our education at the moment. Pretty much in the green, to be fair. Pretty much into the green. So we're not going to put any more educational facilities in just yet. We're trying hard to make sure that we've actually got something going on. Good morning, Seriously Stressed Gamer. How are you, my darling? Hope you are doing well. Hope you're not coughing yet. I appear to believe you have a coffee available. So what I might do, we've got a big, big demand for residential at the moment. So we'll finish this residential area off. This is all high density at the moment. And then we'll see where we go. You're here with the coffee. I'm on number 4, I think. Might have been number 5. I've been up 4 hours already, and it's starting to have an effect. The joys of children, eh? Probably doesn't help that Mrs. Psycho thinks I may now be infected with the lurgy. I don't believe a single word she's saying, though. Someone down the street from you's got it, though, have they? Oh, dear. That's not good. That's not good, is it? It's getting... You know when it gets closer and closer. Right, so we'll let that build up. I'm looking at... Where am I going to go next? We've got our... IT cluster there. Don't really want to put any housing up. Do we want to put housing up behind this? Probably not. This, if we want anything, we might have to expand our campus here. And we have got our overground metro running perfectly well. Look. Where's the camera? There's the camera. Look. Yeah, it's gone. So, yeah, we've gone for a bit of a wide spread, haven't we, really? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 grids in a row. Which is okay. It just, until we start modding with 81 tiles, we need desperate. Oh, we've got flooding, have we? Or is that workers? That's a workers' warning. Looked like a flooding warning for a moment there. But what it does mean is that we've got to work things a little differently, haven't we? It's not like, oh, that one's gone. And until we modded, we've got no changes to road layouts or anything. We can do a complete rebuilding then. But I'm more interested in what we can achieve in vanilla right now. Daylight. We can see what we're doing again. How are they connecting? Are they only connecting? No, it's a dual carriageway. It's dual. For a minute there, I was thinking, this is a highway, isn't it? No, it's a dual carriageway. So we can run down here to a new sort of housing area. And we can even do it with a little bit of... panache, maybe. We've got a bit of a riverside housing going on. They can back their houses onto the river. Make them high value. Pump in a load of schools and free transport and stuff. Maybe give them their own metro station or something.
As I go around the city, I see people doing so many interesting things. Driving, working.
Now that can go right up to
the city has a lot to offer. So what do you do while you listen?
I'd like to have it there actually. Can we put in? I know it sounds odd.
At Akio, we've been making the best mobile phones for over 20 years. How did we get there?
By putting ringtones, because then we can have a couple of houses right on the tip there, you see. That's what I'm thinking. Or just leave it on vibrate. We make sure you always hear your phone in our commercials. And then we'll get the old curly road.
So don't be silenced when opportunity calls, pick it up. It's for you. Akio Mobile.
I'm not convinced that we're gonna put them in as 4x4 low densities. Because then we can have a bit of tree planting going on, sort of in between. Make it more of a... make it more of a secluded estate, so to speak. And we'd leave that there. We'd have houses there, but not there, obviously. Well, we could put houses there, actually. Because they would go up, wouldn't they? It would cause a sort of natural key line. Oh, wrong button. Onto the one next to it. That one. There we go. So if we were to sort of this little bit here, bring that up a bit, because it wasn't going to let us build much, you see. So bring that up a little bit. A bit more. There we go. Then put some more houses along there. Yeah, it's not even really increasing that much, is it? So we'll do that and we'll see how... Yeah, I wanted that third square. It might not let me do it. If I put it three deep there and three deep there, it might naturally adjust the land for us to try and put one there, sort of a couple of 2x3s or even a 4x3. And we can extend that out to there. Might have a park or something. What sort of park can we fit in there? Yeah, it's not going to be great, is it? Could put a park in there. And then there's our access paths for the public to go in. And we can also try and make it a little prettier. Thing is, I would love to be able to use some of the floor tiles in here on vanilla. I know when you mod it, the floor tiles from the city park and from the amusement park and from the zoo are in this. No, it doesn't look like they are, does it? That's a shame. They're not in here, are they? No. Because it would be really nice to use the floor tiles from, I think it was the zoo. Oh, hang on. No, we can. Excellent. Oh, there we go. That's fine. That's fine. Cool. So what we would do is probably flatten this out a little bit to that level. So the play park is slightly above what we're about to build. Ah, there it is. Now, what I'm hoping is that it takes that grass away when we put it down. I'm not sure whether it will or not. Yeah, cool. So obviously what I'm doing is, hey, big city, finally get our hands on the crematorium. We can start burning bodies. Sounds a bit macabre, doesn't it? But it's perfectly fine. We've got our liberal arts college campus area. We've got visiting scholars available. That's a policy rather than a thing that happens. Affects all faculties within the campus area. Increases faculty bonus 25%. Cool. Track and field stadium, that's from the campus DLC. Our new advanced water treatment plants from Sunset Harbors DLC. And I think Large Water Tower came with the new DLC this week as well. So we've got plenty of options there to get some stuff done. And Cryo Preservatory. Yeah, we're not really going to make use of that. No. Right, so let's quickly then, a little more speedily, I should say. It's a shame we can't curve these tiles to match in with the footpath, but for the sake of a couple of millimeters on the screen, beggars can't really be choosers. Quite why 14,000 people would actually want to live in Westfield, run by Mayor Psycho, who knows? So we're going to make this into a little bit of a picnicky parky area to go alongside the parky area that's up the top there. Actually, we'll put the floor down first, is what I'm thinking now. Wrong way, that way, that way, that way, thank you. And we have got a way of hiding these slight imperfections. It's fine. Is it in there? I'm looking for the kiddie sandpits. There we go, it's a sandpit there. That's what I was looking for. We have a sandpit there. A few park benches around that. So that mums and dads can keep an eye on their kiddie winks while they're playing in the sand, so they're not eating it, more important than anything else. And then what we'll do will be really nice. We'll put an ice cream van in. And we'll use some raised flower beds to separate the sand pit with the eating area. It's a shame that's actually a bit too big. It's a bit of a shame that, actually. If it was about half the length, then we could use that a bit more effectively, I reckon. No, yeah, we can't actually move them now, can we? We have to destroy them and start again. Which is fine. And where's that bench? Let's put that bench back. There. Actually, I think we've lost one there, haven't we? I think we put the flower bed down. It's lost it. Right, so while they're busy complaining about the lack of power, let's go and find somewhere for our crematoriums. Now, we've got elder care and we've got child health services there, so that would probably be the most logical place to turn the whole area into a bit of a health and death zone. Don't want it opposite the children's hospital, do we? We want it opposite the health, the elder care hospital. So they can go straight from one to the other. And then we'll put one a bit... Oh! Landfill is 0% full, which is good. That means we can get some more... litter pit. Look, refuse there, problem. And as you would like, people returned to the earth from whence they came. We'll also put in a crematorium so that once the people that are in the ground whence they came are filling up too much, we will place a crematorium so that you can burn them. We'll put it right next door so that you can go along. I'll tell you what, we'll offer viewings. How would you like to be ending your life, madam? Well, I'd like to take a tour of the cemetery, and then I'd like to take a tour of the crematorium so that we can justify the decision that we will make when we die. Well, obviously, you care, madam. You will be dead. Ergo, you won't actually know what we do with your body. Well, it's my choice. Whatever. We digress. Right, so we got our two crematoriums in. Let's go back and carry on building. How are we looking at water? We will need more water intake at some point. We will do it over there. We'll go right over there. And we will upgrade our... poo pipe to become a bit more friendly, so to speak. We'll turn you off in case we get an emergency and we need to have you running. That's now operating normally, which should reflect in our sewage treatment. We might just need a little bit more water. We'll get this wired up in a minute. It'll be fine. It will be perfectly acceptable. And we're only gonna need, I reckon, just the one wind turbine for that. And we'll pump clean water first into our high priority, high value, hopefully, if we work it correctly, housing estate, and that will feed the rest of the world. There we go, have some more water. So what we're planning to do is bring power across from there. Are they going to want... I'm not convinced extending the metro down to this new area is going to work very well. We might just connect it with buses and stuff. Or maybe even a trolley bus or something. I know we've taken trolley buses out. We didn't like them last time, did we? So we'll make Lake Park, again, very high value. We'll bring it right up to Woodland Park there. Hopefully, once we start modding out with things like service districts and individual bus management, it'll work well. So we don't want them to have power and water usage restraints because it's going to be high value. We'd like them to be... No, we will. We will. We'll do it a bit Green City-like. Parks and Rec. Education boost. Not free public transport, no. Prefer parks. Recycle plastic. Automated sorting, what's that? Increase not only mail capacity, but also sorting rate. No. You can have free Wi-Fi with a parks maintenance boost. What's that? That looks like a... Is that our school? It's our school. That's fine. I'm thinking, what's that building there? Right, so where were we? Freeway, book fair, local public library... Teeth back in local public libraries, organise a book fair. Oh, power problem. What's going on? Power problem? Why have you got a power problem? You're connected to the rest of the grid like everybody else. And now you haven't got a power problem. Okay. Whatever. We know you got a power problem. That's fine. Back to Lake Park. Policies. City planning. We'll make it high-tech housing. No high-rises. Old town. That means that you have to have a reason to go in there. VIP area, which includes when we get... we'll make it high-quality. There we go. So, first thing we'll have to do then is put in a disaster mitigation and recovery service. Which we can hide next to the park, can't we? We put it in the next to the park there. Then everyone who's gone to the park to enjoy the tree will be able to go... And evacuate safely when things start to go awry. And we'll just... sort out another bit of the estate. So I want to try... and make sure that we don't have as many power lines as we've had before. So this is all going to be low density stuff. As it's at night, we'll just up the old... No, that's what we want. We'll just up the old speed on that. Have they got water? Actually, they haven't got water, surprisingly. We're setting the water for everyone else, but not the people. Why are you showing a power drain? You're connected to the grid. I'm not convinced I know what's going on here. We're having brownouts for some reason.
Coffee. Fuel economy.
There we go. Age-old Italian tradition of burning the solar updraft tower isn't actually connected to the main grid. I'm sure we did. I know why. I know why. It's because we removed the trolley bus depot. The trolley bus depot was there. So it connected to the solar updraft tower and then connected into the rest of the area. All while generally making more noise than anyone could reasonably. Yes. So drink up. That makes sense. Sort of. Sippy sip coffee fans. Burn bean coffee. Get it while it's hot. Due to recent court actions. Right, so how are they getting on over there? Are these first buildings loading up? They are. Good. Good. No. Low dense. There we go. You know, the honking, barking, yelling, and chirping to listen to the true sounds of the city right here on City's radio. And what we can do is plant some trees between them. Where you are and don't go away. It's Super Salmon Days down at Fish Brothers. So that they feel a little more exclusive. Salmon entree free. You heard right. Bring in any fish. Morning, Sabiko. Did you just see Weird Gunk on the road coming from the main city towards the updraft tower? Weird Gunk? What, you mean trams? Or metros? Or what? Define Weird Gunk. Or do you mean that? That doesn't look right, does it? I thought that was trees. It's not, it's bushes. Put trees in. Yeah, for some... Well, I put that down yesterday. I was convinced that was trees. Clearly not. There we go. They can have trees now. And I know I said yesterday we're going to have a look at this tram route, and that's exactly what we're going to do. The downside is this bleeding metro track's now in the way. What I wanted to do was run from here down to here. And I'm not convinced I'll get that through. I don't think it's going to let me somehow. Nope. So we might not do that. Can you cross metro tracks over tram tracks? No. And those tracks can't cross over each other anyway, so I can't put it there. That's a shame. That is a shame. What we'll have to do then... And we might end up putting a tram down that way. Academic year report. One academic work. 181 students. Just up the metro a bit longer. Maybe. Thing is, if you put the metro up a bit longer, yeah, it could do. I'm going to try something else first. Camping for Tractors, 500, which is plus 10, but we are still unrecognised. Now, we did get as big city. Didn't we get that policy that we can have? There we go. Visiting scholars. Varsity Sports Fan Club Support. Varsity team gives out free fan merchandise to fans during matches and organises fan club trips to away matches. Increases the odds of winning a home and away by 7%, but costs 180 credits a week per arena. No. Student healthcare. Students provide free healthcare. Nope. We'll do free lunch, though. They can have free lunch. We'll just put it down as a government expense. It'll be fine. Anyway, how are you doing this morning, Sabiko? Have you remembered to adjust your... Do you adjust your clock, is the question. Yeah, I suppose we could up that a little longer, couldn't we? Do that. Let's have a look. Oh. Tonight, you guess? Oh, we did ours last night, mate. That's what I was asking. Yeah, that's not going to work, is it? Gonna have to go around here somehow. Oh, 60% of your clocks are automatic. Well, that makes it easier, doesn't it, I suppose. Is that going to work? Yeah, sort of. It sort of works. We'll tidy it up later. We'll tidy it up once we've got Move It on the go. So got that, then we'll upgrade this. No, this is still no mod. This is still vanilla, Sabrika. It is definitely still vanilla. We might mod later is what I was alluding to. Not later today, but once we've got a nice big 9 squares and loads of people in our city, I might put the mods in. Sort of like the last couple of streams of the series, if it becomes a series. I don't know if it's going to become a series. I haven't decided if it's to become a series yet, to be fair. And then what we need to do is move these trams out of our tram depot. Oh yeah, that's why, isn't it? Because we've still got these stops here to deal with. We're going to put... Let's just take those stops out altogether. There we go. We'll put those stops in. We won't confuse the game. It's not appropriate to confuse the game anymore. So there's our new tram stops. And then people, if they want to go to the bus depot at the bus station here, and just cross over, walk down, cross over again. It'll be fine. It will be fine. It will. We'll let that delve in while we come back to our new lake park. And we're going to put a post office in. We haven't done sorting centre yet. We have got the sorting facility now, but we haven't done it. So we'll work our way down towards the sorting centre there, the post office there, sorry. And we'll just put some nice trees in. Is there room to put trees between? There we go. You have some trees between you. Let's enforce some additional social isolation, shall we? The unnatural way. We're going to just chuck trees in. Not that they're going to make it look like you're all semi-enclosed. And then we'll come and chop all the trees down at the end of the outbreak. That'll work. It'll work fine. It'll be fine. Right, they're all connected up, and the park's connected up, which is good. We've got any kids out playing tonight? No, good. We might have to send the police to enforce the lockdown and give them their fines. And we'll just do a footpath out towards the evacuation center and the park. I just make things a little more pretty. They're going to complain that they're not going to get any sunlight, aren't they? We have not got any sun because you put those damned trees in the way, and I now can't get my tan. I'm so sorry. Tough. Right, so, as we've now got them, let's take a look at our public transport provision for them. They're not going to like it, but they're going to have to share a bus service with Woodland Park. And it's not... Oh, are we not connected something there? Oh, that's just a tram line. That's fine. We might just do them a tram, you see. Let's do the tram all the way down to about there. This is all very eco. They're going to want trams in an eco area. What we got there? What's that? Can we move that? That's the community school. Can we move it just down a little bit? Like that. I don't know why they're complaining. They've still got a bleeding... Oh, it's the wrong one. They've still got a bleeding community school. Why are they complaining? City looks a lot like a train to you somehow. What, in terms of graphics? Or just in terms of the fact that I'm spending more time on public transport provision than anything else? Why did that cause those two houses to disappear? Just clusters and huge high-rise in the middle of nowhere. Well, we're going to build it out. We're going to build it out, don't worry. This is all going to become a big conurbation at some point. And then we're going to have big civil wars between Woodland Park and the high-rise... And the Birdsong Park people who don't like high-rise and litter and are very eco. And they'll merge in... No, I'm not saying you are criticising. If you were criticising, I'll tell you to shut up. But we're going to build it into a big conurbation, don't worry. And we'll turn this into a museum or something. Eventually... Oh, where's that coming in? No, we can't really do that. I don't like that, actually. Don't like that now. Don't like that idea now. I've got a better idea. He's got an idea. He's got an idea. Don't tell Molly and Mac he's got an idea, because they can do a silly song and dance again. What I'm going to do, actually, is run it. What I want to do is run it right along the seafront. A bit Blackpool-y. If anyone's ever been to Blackpool. No, there we go, thank you. Why are they complaining? They're going to get a tram service right along their seafront and they're complaining? our kingdom will fall. Yeah, that's not going to help, is it? Right. Let's drop this a little bit for now. It might work in a minute. It might not. Doesn't see that as a... Oh, what we got here? Oh, balls. Pants, pants, pants. Pants. So we have to raise this up. Raise me up and stick me in a mountain. No, no, that's not the lyrics. I know, I know. We are the law. Maybe I have got coronavirus and it's slowly turning me into a raving lunatic. Well, I wouldn't quite say slowly. I'd probably say I already am a raving lunatic. Is that us? Well, what do you think? Seems to me that there's a lot of you out there who might need the use of the law accounting. But that's not legal advice. That's life advice. In fact, we're legally barred from... Just move this in a little bit. Make it hyper-aggressive. There we go. That's better. Not quite as aggressive, though, please. Thank you. As a radio host, I feel like I have the best job in the world. I get to sit in a studio for hours and hours listening to my favorite music and talking to people that almost never talk about. The problem is, at that point, we're then going to have to either move that ferry terminal or put the tram down the road. Well, you got the fishing village as well. So we could run the tram along the front here. What I'm thinking. So you're wondering, I gather you usually don't like 4X and war games. But what about other buildy games like Colony Survival, Minecraft, Kingdoms? I don't necessarily not like 4X games. I've not really got on with them at the moment, to be fair. Yeah, right. Jubilee. Be reasonable or be But I've got Surviving Mars, I've got Transport Fever, which sort of start to match along, don't they? I want to get back into Civ 6. I want to get into Heart of Iron 4 because I like the idea. I just can't get started. That's where my problem is. They're my stock, aren't they? The question about more buildy, less city. I would probably give any game along that sort of line a go. I'm not someone who just looks at a game generally and goes, I will never play that because of. If there's anything that I think that I would enjoy about the game, I'll give it a go. At the moment, it's more about cost. That's the issue at the moment. Why is that not upgrading? Oh, no. It's not going to let me upgrade that, is it? Because it's a bloomin'... It's not a road. That doesn't work. It doesn't work. If you're going to let me build houses next to a road that's part of a building, let me bleeding put tram tracks on it as well. Academic year report. Campus attractiveness down 60. Why? What? Because I've got touring scholars. Let me have a think about that. We'll come back to that in a minute. I'm going to have a think about that. Why? What I can do then. To be fair, I've not heard or played or Medieval Engineer, so I can't say that I would or I wouldn't play it. Why is my campus lacking in we've got all this money we're investing into academic works. Basketball and swimming. 1-2 matches lost, 3 matches, 5 in total. We'll lower the price of the Buccaneers. We'll lower the viewing price to 20. Cheerleading budget. Funding cheerleading increases the varsity team chances of winning. Cheerleading also increases the varsity sports attractiveness. Well, it depends if they're attractive cheerleaders, doesn't it? But we'll put 200 credits currency in. 202 is apparently as close as we get. And hire more coaching staff so we've got more chances of winning. First person, so a bit more like Satisfactory, but Medieval. Again, I would have loved to have played Satisfactory, but it came out at a time where I didn't have enough cash to justify it. Now, can I do anything to sort this? What I would rather... What I'm thinking is, because of the tramway, it's kind of causing an issue, isn't it? And a lot of these people are going in there. Now, if I had TMPE, I would mitigate that and always allow left turns into that road. Its economic model is more based on lugging stuff around yourself, so no automate, almost no auto. Okay. Okay. Well, I might. Well, if they're shutting it down, then there might not be any point me looking at it. But. We'll have a look. We'll have a look one day. I'll see what I can do. It was just traffic lights. You can't force lane changes. Certainly, I don't remember being able to force lane changes in vanilla. Let's have a look. We can make it a priority route. We can make that a priority road. That might help. Maybe. We'll put it on priority route. We'll see. Look, a lot of these vehicles, I reckon. So a lot of them are going there, but is an equal amount going that way? The main problem with Medieval Engineer is the building tools are super janky and borderline unusable, otherwise be a nice sandcastle experience. So that reminds me of some bits of this and some bits of Transport Fever too, to be fair. Make that into a 3-lane highway. With a dedicated right turn, that might help. Although what I could do is turn those lights off and turn those lights on to try and mitigate against this. Oh, we have got lights on there. If I turn those lights off... Where does it then backs up to there, doesn't it? Where's my next tram? Is that going to cause an issue? Don't think it will, actually. We've got a problem here with trams backing up against each other. Can I make that tramway a priority route? Will that work? Priority road. Let's see if that helps. We still haven't built our tram down here yet, though, which is a problem. Because I'm now not sure what we're going to do with it. I suppose we could. I wonder if we can get that to go underground quick enough. So if we had... from there... sort of basically a tunnel. Reset that down to 3. 1, 2, 3. I'm not convinced, though, that it will look any good. So run it there, and then upgrade all of this bit. Oh, got another ferry terminal there. What's there? Taxes too high. Okay, we'll lower the taxes. Then we've got a bit of cash at the moment. We'll lower all their taxes. Like that. Oh, too late. They've already abandoned. That's a shame. I suppose. I wonder if it'll mean losing that one building there. As a non-Brit, I have to say 90% of your traffic problems are the simulation doesn't play rail with roundabouts. You're right. Absolutely right. I know. I know. Roundabouts are a pain in this game. No. Not convert it. We want to remove the road. There we go. Absolutely right. So we'll run our tram up here to the metro station. Up like that. Oh, pants. Really? Really? And then we'll just... run it to there or something. I wonder if workers and resources vehicles do stop at junctions. I wouldn't like to commit an answer on the basis that I haven't played it in quite some time. I need to get back to that game because I missed that. But each time I've played it, I've got there and I'm thinking, the problem that I have with workers and resources, or the problem I had with workers and resources, because I don't know if they fixed it, is that the whole idea that the only way you can really make a start is to start with an establishment of zero buildings rather than the pre-made town does make it something that I wasn't really overly keen on, I must admit. You know me, I like to admit things like that. So what we'll do is we'll put those there like that. We'll put our paths back in. And I want to put a path back in there, don't I, to the there, like that. So that they can get to the emergency evacuation tower in the most expeditious way possible. I think that works. What we've got, what I want to do is see if I can put an extra tram stop there. I don't think we're going to be able to. At least that is what puts me off. But I still built a town that did almost all the things that game offered at that point. Now they added a ton of stuff and it's still the same janky interface and building mode. Yes. Absolutely agree there. Absolutely agree. I wonder. Wonder if I can get away and moving that ferry point to there. So I can stick a tram stop in. The answer's no. Okay, that's fine. That is fine. To take you to another place or time. And there's no better place to watch than Drone Cinema. And no better time than the time it we might have lost a few people, but you'll break box office records of fun as you take a trip to I'd like to have had a tram stop there, you see. Guaranteeing the only thing you hear is the movement. That high-pitched shuttle drone is normal. It's the sound your ears hear when there's nothing for your ears to hear here. So come on down and enjoy the other option. I really like being a radio host, but if I could change one thing, it would probably be to academic year report attractiveness up 6, students down 104 to 192. Really? Okay. Some things not right with campus there. We will have to. I will have to take a look at that. What I want to do first, though. No, wrong way. Drop this down a little bit. Probably a little too much. So if I put it right to under there, at what point is it? It's not even going to slightly work, is it? Giants roamed the earth, grazing pants. Off the lush vegetation of the time. Pants. Their mere existence transformed the landscape and made a lasting impact on our world. It's that legacy that Dino Oil is proud to continue. By using their eons old dead bone goop to fuel your five door wagon. Make so we're just going to have a stop here. Recycling there is. And then a stop Dino there. It's not going to work any other way unless I completely rebuild. Listener, So I could just put the tram along the top here at Birdsong Park, down Finch Street, change that into a tram plus road. So do that. They're eco-friendly. They're fine. They like a bit of eco-development work, as long as it means that we quell to their everlasting demands to have ecological abundance or something. Anyone wants to change between tram and ferry boat is perfectly happy to walk down the slope two blocks. Oh, and the traffic never changing lanes and teleporting home from work, of course. Oh, changing lines, yes. I think that coming back to City Skylines, of course, if we were to... Oh, those houses have gone again, haven't they? Oh, well, that's a shame. Of course, we've got the dynamic lane selection, the dynamic calculating of routes that goes on now in CS in some of the mods. What was it in TMPE or real time? It's one of them. I think it's TMPE, isn't it? If that was able to be incorporated without too much of a performance hit in the main game, brilliant. At the end of the day. Oh, I've got an Amazon order out for delivery. You know they're saying it's going to take 4 weeks to deliver non-essential items from Amazon. I've got a non-essential item coming today. Well, it's not non-essential for me. It's non-essential by their decree. So, we're going to get this tram service going. And we'll run the trams. There we go, we can let them go by tram to the community pool. There we go. After all, it's exactly performance that made Colossal Order not do it. Yeah. Yeah, well, I know that's one of the problems, isn't it, to be fair. And we'll send the trams up to the campus so that we can get more people educated. And what I want to do eventually is extend the tram from the eco district through campus all the way to the industrial area. But I'm going to be rebuilding a lot of it, aren't I, so... It's not the most urgent thing in the world right now. I don't really do Amazon, but I have ordered a hygienic cover, keyboard cover for work. It's now 10 days late, but it says ready for shipping today. Oh dear. No, I don't have that issue, to be fair. Usually, occasionally, because I get all my bulk stuff, and I always have got my bulk stuff, so it's not that I'm panic buying. But when I buy my 54 toilet rolls every 3 months or whatever it is, or 5 months, I can't remember. I think we've got it set to something like 3 or 6 months, and then we generally push it back a month, or we bring it in a month sometimes, depending on how quickly we've used them. Anyway, we digress. The only problem I generally have is when they run out, so they can't deliver, and they won't tell you until the day after they're meant to have dispatched it that they haven't got any in stock, so they are regretfully cancelling your order. That's annoying, but I don't generally have a huge problem with them. Unlike some streamers who whinge and moan every day about them, I may hasten to add. You haven't got my highly specialised Elgato Stream Deck XL Edition in stock. Disgraceful behaviour. I'll have to go to a specialist provider. Yeah, go on then. They say it's out of stock. It's out of stock. So we're gonna have to put some. We'll put some more footpaths in. We'll put a footpath in there and there, so that people can get to the tram. Like I know we've all had to lament home delivery providers at the moment. And it does annoy me that I have not been able to get any home delivery slots for online grocery shopping for the last month. But these are exceptional times at the moment. Actually, I'll put a little corner shop in there. Greetings, Kill Bill 2. How are you, my friend? Happy Sunday to you. I hope this Sabbath day treats you well. As you can see, we are all deeply religious in prayer. We are praising City Skylines. Trying really hard not to moan about it, but we are praising them. Let's put some more trees in here. Have I got enough earthquake? This is one of our VIP areas. Has our earthquake sensor covered this area? No. This would be the perfect place to put an earthquake sensor. Right in the middle there. Because it's not in the way. It's not causing any problems. You're doing good. That is great to hear. Also, lots of Amazon third-party stuff don't deliver to Switzerland. Well, yeah, third-party stuff can be hit and miss. I try, because I have got Amazon Prime, so I do try and go for the Prime stuff that's delivered directly by Amazon. There are some things that it doesn't, that they just don't do. Mrs. Psycho has a particular panache for chocolate cappuccinos on Tassimo, which is fine, but it's only available on Amazon through third-party sellers in the UK. So that's something that we do have to get from third party. Where's that one? Oh, it's that one we wanted to see raise up, wasn't it? Wonder if it's going to do it. No? Oh, that's a shame. We'll just do it as a 2x4 then. I'd just walk into the shop to get something like that. Yeah, well, I would if any of the shops did it, Sabiko. That is one of the core problems around here. We've got three reasonably sized supermarkets. We've got four reasonably sized supermarkets, one from each of the core supermarket providers, and none of them do it. They do a range of Tassimo coffee pods, but not Jacob's chocolate cappuccino. So I either have to order it directly from Tassimo at very great expense, and we have to do an order that's like 45 quid's worth, or we get it from Amazon, but then we buy it in bulk. So we buy 5 packets of 8 rather than 1 packet of 8. I've been into central London, had Lux Tobiko. No one in central London even does it. I would get on the train for an hour, mainly because it's free for me, and go and have a look. But when I've been to have a look, no one seems to do it. Well, also, all that easy coffee stuff is invented in Switzerland. So, for example, we have Nestle slots that only sell the capsules. Yeah, Nestle do Nespresso shops and pop-up shops in the UK. So I wouldn't actually do it. I wouldn't go from this town to the next town by train. Although that charge is £1.70. That's not free. That's 75% off. Where they do have an espresso shop in the shopping centre. It's probably not open at the moment under lockdown. But yeah, that's Nespresso. That's not Tassimo, unfortunately, for me. Right, let's get some buses here to Lake Park. And that can go... I want to go this way. Am I gonna have to put a bus stop there, so that you definitely go this way? Right. If that's what you want, that's what you get. Actually, if I do, yeah, it's still. Why? No. Why? 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 Doesn't matter which way. I want you to go the scenic route. Why can't I put a waypoint in? I've got to put a bus stop in. So what do you do with that and that? That's why, game. And then what I'll do is run you across the seafront there, up to the school, to the cemetery. And back, and that's all we're going to do with you, actually. That's all we're going to do. Because then you've got access to the metro station. You've done it again, game. You know how to wind me up, game, don't you? Like that, there we... No, to there. See, you know how to wind me up, game, don't you? Hang on, right, Tassimo is Chibo. No, Jacobs. Filthy Germans. What? No, Tassimo is Tassimo. Most Tassimo machines are, academic year, no students, no attractiveness in the campus, no academic words, disgraceful. What's going on up here? Why are we less attractive? Are we winning more matches? No. Oh, yeah, no. No, we're not winning more matches. We're winning more swimming. Let's take off the free lunches then. And the academic scholars. And we'll see what effect that has. See, we're reputation unrecognised. So what do we do to get to the next level? A campus attractive... Oh, we've got to get more students and more academic works. Right, that makes sense. Tassimo's Jacobs is crafts is... Bosch make the Tassimo machines. I don't know what you've got over there, Sabiko, but... We've got Costa do pods now for Tassimo. Jacobs do pods now for Tassimo. Law, which is Carte Noire, does it. Yeah, it's just yeah, they are just the contractor. But anyway, We've digressed onto coffee. I finished my coffee. I've got about 45 minutes though till I have to go and get my next coffee. It's fine. It's fine. So we've got our tram service. You don't even drink coffee. Sorry. We've got trams running. Oh, look, there's our high-speed trams. It's because it's in high-speed mode. There's our trams making their way up to the campus area. I'm going to extend that tram on the campus area, from the campus area down here. It's almost going to be like a metro, isn't it? That's the problem. And then I would bring it around here somewhere to the industrial area. This is where I would like to use the metro to a way that I would want to use it. Oh, the cemetery's empty. Good, good. Go get some dead people. Because there's our metro station. It then goes underground to an underground metro station there, and then goes underground and back out to the ground level. Surface level metro station there. What would be really good is to get the tram from here down over or under the highway. Maybe have a tram stop there and then join the metro under here to go into the industrial area. Coffee, an interesting topic. Behave. Behave. Interesting topic. Right, so let's do that. So we've got to convert that into a tram road. And then we'll do... Oh, we ain't got any snapping anymore. There we go, we've got snapping now. So 5x5.
Last year,
empires fell and rose on coffee. Don't diss the original black gold. I call it black gold as well, and then people say, what are you being racist for?
Into the cutthroat world of real estate. Horse economy 3, stable markets. Can you work your way from lowly horse?
Right, so what am I doing?
Can you spin your holdings into a billion dollars?
What am I doing? Is that straight? Is that gonna be level? Yeah, cool. That's not going down another 9, which is not what I want.
Pre-order now and get a free horse hat. Horse Economy 3, stable markets. Buy low, sell hay.
Buy low, sell hay. Allegedly.
I'm your host, Elle, and you're listening to Cities.
So we're going to up that to surface level. All right. It's not... I've got to push it a little bit further, have I? That's fine. I wanted to connect it to that. But it doesn't like that, does it? So I'm going to have to. Is that going to let me do that? Too slope, too steep. Oh, there we go. Look, see? See?
The number one dream makers in the region. And you are a motivated, driven, confident individual who has a desire to make it big. Run! Don't walk! Get your heart rate above 120. This is,
and then we'll have to convert this road instead. It'll be fine. There we go. Convert that road like that.
So don't wait. The early bird catches the worm, and the worm is a bus at 143 industrial.
Like that.
That leaves it dawn. So grab destiny.
Will people walk to it there? I'm not entirely sure.
Money for nothing.
I was going to say, I'm not entirely sure. That's the question. Hang on.
This is Elle, playing you the best music around. Don't go away, because I'll be here pretty much all day.
Right, I'm fine. I'm fine. Don't call me an ambulance just yet. It was just a cough. So, then, what? No, you're fine. Don't worry about that. Right. So, we'd then extend it down to that tram stop there at Eldercare, wouldn't we? would have to do that. I don't want to do that. What I want to do is put it into the industrial area. So we'd have to go either over or under. Could go under to come out there next to this path. Wonder if that will work. Wonder if that will work. Is it gonna let me? Come on! It sort of wants to let me. Right, now, will it let me drop down? It's not going to be too... There you go, it's not too steep. Slope too steep. Have a heart game. Have a heart. There we go. And to be fair, we could probably send both of the trams down there and just have the tiniest of turning circles here where we're not actually going to have passengers on in theory. It'll be a bit like the Northern Line, though. You're not meant to travel along the empty stock turning circle on the Northern Line. But people do it. People deliberately do it as well. And the thing is, the tight times that the Northern Line Underground has, they can't really stop them. So, where is... I think it's that one. Yep, cool. It's that one. So we can stop the trams there for the university still. We'll stop them there for that housing estate. What I might have to do is take... Hang on. Yeah, we don't want to see tram... We want to see tram line 2, not tram line 1. Thank you, game. Cheers, game. My kingdom will fall. My kingdom will fall. Where's the tram stops here? There. There it is. Your kingdom will fall. It will fall without coffee. You are absolutely right. Kingdoms will fall without coffee. I know what I need to do as well is extend that bus route down to this Spurman ferry terminal, don't I? Like that. And then have a pair of bus stops there. Because we've got people going to the ferry, but they're not actually going to be able to do anything but walk. Does that mean no one's on there? One person's on there, see? Are they getting off? No. People are actually getting... All right. People are getting on. All right. You win, game. You win. And we'll just do a little turning circle for the bus. Or not. We can do it. We'll just lower the land. It'll be fine. It'll be fine, he says, maybe. Hoping. And we won't want any parking, actually, so we'll do it as a one-lane highway, highway slip road. No. Let's lower this bit out a bit. We'll still do our little turning circle. Saves the bus going all the way up to the top of the road, you see. There we go. To be fair, it's probably not going to save it a huge amount, but... now, do I want to extend that tram up into the industrial estate, or can they just change? They can just change trams. It'll be fine. Now, what's causing delays here? Is it the trams? Or is it just the fact that there's too many people trying to get into... Right, okay, that's fine. What we can do, we'll extend that out to a third lane to try and mitigate the number of people in the wrong lane, so to speak. It might work, it might not. Where are you going? You're on bus line one. Why did you just come out of this road and all the way round out to that road? Why are you on bus? How many bus lines are you using this motorway now? Oh, there are two that use it. Okie dokie. All right, that's fine. You win, game. You win. Oh, we got sickness. What's this? Noise or pollution? Noise pollution. So it is pollution. Noise pollution. Let's put some trees in your road then. Let's treeify this area. Is that a word, treeify? You know what? We still haven't seen a sing... Oh! Balls. Can't put trees there, can we? Because of the tram tracks. Can't have trees and tram tracks. That's disgraceful understanding of things. How are we doing down here now? Right, so we're building up slowly. Need more industry now, don't we? Ooh, my package, not only my Amazon package, not only on its way, it says it's 6 stops away despite estimated arrival 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. Do you get the feeling that the driver's able to do 6.5 million miles an hour to get here? Might be something to do with the fact there's no roads. There is roads. There's no traffic. Right, so we haven't put many shops in. Will that be enough shop action? I think not. We're gonna make that into commercial premises now. And we'll whiz through the night. 6 stop for him could be 6 houses. Yeah. Oh no, but there is that. He is in our town though right now. We can track him, and he is at the top end of our estate, so he won't be long. It won't be long. And quite often, if Mrs. Psycho's ordered something and I've ordered something, oh, we're out of order, are we? Okay, we'll get rid of this then. Yeah, we'll destroy you, that's fine. Ore production is flooring it now, so we're going to look at probably getting rid of our ore industry area. What was I saying? I was saying that looks good for farming. That's what I was saying. Now, what I was saying was Mrs. Psycho and I could do two different orders, and it will say it's two places away, two stops away, and one of the stops is in fact either me or Mrs. Psycho, and the other one is right after. So we can happily confuse Amazon in one way or another. Right, this is going to be our new industry area. This is farming. Farming,
it's
people,
super
farming.
Salmon days down at Fish Brothers. For a limited time, bring in any fish and get a child salmon entree free. You heard me.
And our access to the farming district is going to be off of this minor road here.
Any fish. Got a swordfish lying around? Bring it in.
Not with trams, game. Not with traps.
Got a fish that's been sitting in the sun for a few days? Bring it in.
No, wrong one. Wrong button. That button. That's what I was looking for. Farming.
Just enjoy your salmon, $8.99 with our famous stew.
And we're going to start farming there. We can now have some animal pastures, some crop fields, some fruit fields. And that's a renewable source, isn't it? So we're not going to have the problem that we have with the ore in that it disappears and runs out. And we will indeed have to move these, I think, these turbines. We'll put the turbines out here.
The weird thing was, nobody seemed to want to talk about it. Maybe it was too scary. Actually,
like
if things
that
just disappear randomly, maybe I can disappear. That is scary. I need to play another song.
And then we will,
hi, I'm Greg, owner and founder,
extend
Steel Frame Spots,
the road up to, but not at, not on the metro. We'll put a metro station in there, you see. Hopefully.
Instead,
if we can get it in there right,
you the lowest price.
I bet we can't. I bet we cannot put a
teams, you can count on us
ground level metro
year
station in that room, in that space
I'll
there.
The ball on prices,
you know it's not going to be possible.
And my customers' happiness are not affected by the short fingers.
Which side is all the greenery?
Just
both
remember,
sides.
When the game's on the
typical
line, who do you count on? Steel Frame Spots. That's
gonna try and put my tube station
in
there.
In the weekly nickel.
Coffee.
One too far. I think. Grand City, 17,000 population. They are glutton for punishment. We've got baseball parks, solar power plants, waste transfer facilities.
Our coffee technicians are trained. Make a variety of coffees.
They use garbage trucks to collect and temporarily store garbage. Stored waste can be picked up by waste transfer trucks from waste processing complex. The building pollutes less, certainly built closer to the city center. So the waste processing complex sends out waste transfer trucks to pick up garbage from the waste transfer facilities and landfill sites for further processing into energy and recycled materials. Cool. Intercity bus terminal is now available. That's a larger one for the one we've already got. And the bus metro super hub, where tracks will go in four directions, and we've got a bus station. Cool. Not. Doesn't. I don't care. Don't care. What have we got to do for this? We've got to move it down one, haven't we? This is where we find that I don't actually move it at all. So we can put it there and reroute the track. Excellent. This is predominantly for the factory workers, you see. So we will get our metro station will do a stop there and a stop there. We'll get the metro station some water. Like that. You got water? You got water. Excellent. It's kind of, oh, here we go. Got no power now. Have some power. You'll get power in a minute. You'll be fine. What we'll do is we'll put some fields right next to you. Like that. And then we'll find we can't actually... We've got to move you now, haven't we? Got to move you down to there. And we can do cheaper roads, actually. We can do the old industrial... There's an industrial road, look. Wait, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There we go. There we go. That's where we can put more fields. I don't think it really matters what food we plant, does it? That looks okay at the moment. We can put a processing center there somewhere at some point. That's right on the edge of the fertile land, though. We all know about fertile land. We're going to have fertile land in order to have our fields. How fertile? Oh, no. All right, game. It's fine. We'll put the road back. Can't put the road back. There we go. Have a road. There we go. People can now get off the metro and go to work. There aren't many workers yet. There will be. What's our unemployment level? 7%. So people will be forced to go to work. They will work the fields. And they will like it. Sorry. They will like it. No complaints from Woodland Park at the moment. No complaints from Lake Park. So our building... Oh, has there been a bit of fire there? Looks like there has. We have got our fire helicopter service though, so they should have been able to put it all out. Let's have a quick look along our stats, shall we? Crime is low, but we are up nearly up to capacity. We were nearly up to capacity. Pollution is fine. People are sick there because of the pollution. So I might have to close this industrial area down. Which is a bit of a shame. It's not really. That was our original industrial area. So let's get rid of that. We've got any bus. I've got a bus stop there as well. Gotta take that bus stop off. We'll take that bus stop off. You don't need to go that way anymore, driver. Nobody's told you yet, but you don't have to go that way anymore. And we can get rid of this road as well. Like that. Oh, look at all these trams queuing up everywhere. Really? Really? Tell you what we'll do is we'll make that a priority road as well. Which is good, because it includes the tram road, which is probably better than using the roundabout. Anyway. Oh, got some noise pollution issues there. Noise pollution? Where from? The road itself.
and that road there.
All we can really do is cover it all up with trees, I think. But you are in a high rise, so you've got to expect it to be a little noisy, guys. Especially as we've reduced the tax that you have to pay. There we go. This is where we need tree brush, isn't it? Is that enough to block the noise out? Is this going to help? Probably not. Probably just a big, big waste of the money that we've got saved up in our tax coffers. There we go. Is that going to help you? Probably not. See here, look. We've got two trams tailgating each other. And we've now got a queue of trams here. Maybe we need to get rid of these two access points. Maybe that will help with the issues that we currently have with complaints about. There we go. That's how we do it. I suspect the commercial buildings bit as well is probably not helpful. And we'll just dezone all of this for now and rebuild it. No, dezone. Dezone! And you. So what we're going to do is we're going to place our high-rise buildings here now. And have 2x4 high-density commercial there. That's the idea. That's going to be the plan. It could be a completely disingenuous plan. And of course, we've got all the comedy clubs there. They are indeed seafood delicacies? Really? Where's the one that I put there? Where's the one that I renamed? Where's my Stand and Deliver Comedy Club? What's happened to Stand and Deliver Comedy Club? Is it gone? I'm sure I built it there. There's they've all leveled up, so the comedy club's closed. No. Okay. It's fine, game. It's fine. You don't want me to do some random titles of places that may or may not reflect places that, yeah, places for people that actually I've been to see. And I tried to give free damn promotion to, stupid game. Right, so we're going to extend this out like this. We're not going to put any there. We're going to put a park there or something. It's got to be some sort of thing that we can put there. Like a park, that's going to destroy everything. Like a park, that's going to destroy everything. That's going to destroy everything. There we go. So we can put a couple of parks along there. It's fine. We know they're separate parks. We know they're going to look like separate parks. But indeed, unfortunately, we're tough. How are they? Are they building up now? Yeah, cool. We'll do that there, look. We'll put another one there. And we'll finish off there with our high density commercial. How are we getting on? Have we got full staffing now? Almost, almost. Almost, good, right. So we've got the metro, don't need a bus service up there or anything like that. Oh, we've got a dead person there. We've got death care up here somewhere, haven't we? Look, we've got a cemetery, which is only two-thirds full, and we've got a crematorium, which is not actually storing anyone at the moment. And it all seems rather happy there, apart from the awaiting a collection of a dead person. You're not really going to get any better there, Elizabeth Residence. It's a bit noisy because there's a big metro system there. And that metro's there for you to travel on, Elizabeth Residence. So you haven't really got a choice. It's going to stay. It's going to be staying there for quite some time. How busy are these trams then? Six on. None on. So it might not have been a useful thing to extend out there. I'll tell you what, as it's... oh, what we got? Oh, that's right. That's fine. That's that poo pipe that we've turned off at the moment. And while it's in darkness, and that seems to be quite a good point in time, that we might consider taking a very short break. So it's 10 to 12. We've been at this now for just under 2 hours. So what are we going to do? We're going to do cinematics. There we go. We'll even leave it going. We won't do what we usually do and pause it. And hopefully we'll come back and find that this city hasn't fallen into such disrepair. We're going to be taking a few minutes. You need to take a few minutes as well. Go answer the call of nature. Grab yourself a coffee, coke or beer. Be back right here in just a few minutes' time. And we'll keep building across our Sunset Harbour in Vanilla. For those watching on Twitch, as always, sorry, it's a minute of ads. For those on YouTube, you're just going to get lovely cinematics. Be right back.
Bring the whole family to At the Old Grain Mill, old-fashioned family restaurant. At the Old Grain Mill always has the best service and the best home-style meals in town. We'll make sure you always leave At the Old Grain Mill with a smile and a full belly. Now, be sure that you come down to At the Old Grain Mill, old-fashioned family restaurant, and not the abandoned grain facility at the edge of town. It's not safe for visitors and poses serious risks to anyone who dares enter that old place. Forced to close down years ago, we ordered our signed uniforms before we learned of the existence of that dangerous old firewall, so we are not responsible for what happened there on that awful, awful night. We just want to focus on making great meals every night at the Old Grain Mill. Old-fashioned family restaurant at the Old Grain Mill, from our family to yours.
Welcome back. Hello, I wonder, do trams in the UK make the weird cling-clong sound? Some do. Some do. It depends where you are. Trams that are running off the track obviously don't need to. But there are trams that run through the city centre sharing roads. A bit like these, so they would. Oh, come on, trams. Really? Look how many trams are in this queue. We need TMPE to manage them and mitigate them. Might have to turn that into a roundabout. Although we know that roundabouts don't really work. Budget. Let's lower the tram budget down then. Because the trams do have a high budget at the moment to get people moving. And none of it's really making a profit. We're subsidising all public transportation at the moment. Composed of industrial plastics, polymers, and 10% of all of our expenses come from public transportation. That's a shame. And that's why it can also carry up to 300 kilograms of... Here they're more like an angry bell-based siren. Yeah, I think they're more like car horns here, to be fair. In fact, it is a perfect vessel for transport from short to medium distances, and we believe that the... Right. How are we doing up here with our workers? Fully staffed now. Near enough, which is what we like to see. So we'll put in some more. Industry area. So we're outputting 56 tons of crops. Produce resource units until next level. We've got enough workers for the next level. We've got getting two. Enough resources for the next level. So we'll start doing some storage, I reckon. And we'll extend out and we'll do a little storage area here. Because it seems that putting them on the main roads isn't really very effective. Congratulations, level 2. Efficiency up, pollution down, and we got a flour mill and a bakery. Excellent. Now, where are we going to do storage? I'm thinking here. No, not a cattle shed. Small grain silo. There we go, 4 of those. And what we can do then is make this into a cattle area. So where's our pasture? There's our pastures. Not an industry area. They need fertile land. No. Good. But we will eventually need a flour mill. Oh, No water. Sorry, cows, sheep, chickens. There you go, have some water. Why is my email still on? That's what's worrying me. I didn't turn that email on. Bing. No. Right, so let's have a look. They're happy there, Lake Park. They're happy there, Woodland Park. A little bit of crime. There's a police station there, so I'm not sure why. There's a little bit of a crime issue there at the Barlow residence, because the police cars can get around fairly quickly. Is there a police car? Here, police car. Nope, okie dokie. That looks... Is that a home delivery van there? No, it's just a farm truck. Oh, that's a shame. It's not our farm truck either. It's another city's farm truck. Disgraceful. What's up with you? Not enough crops. We not got enough crops? Put some more crop fields in if that's what you want. Small crop field. You want more crops? You can have more crops. There we go. Have more crops. More crops, sir. Doesn't matter what sort of crops. It's just crops. You need water, do you? You now need water. Okie dokie. Have some water. Where are you going? You're en route. That's nice. You're flooding. That's not so nice. Has that just basically fallen? Have we completely neglected that that's... What? What? Can't believe we got it that low. Might have to take that stop out for now, then, and rebuild that. No, I don't want to create a new line. No, I don't want to create a new line. I want to raise the land so that we don't flood the line that we've got. Sir. That looks a bit higher, which is good. Has that now immediately dropped it back down? No. Good. It's not as bad as it was, but it's bad. So we now need to sort the ferry out. Need to reroute the... There we go, like that. And then... Do that. Come on, get out the way, boat. Out the way. I need to reset these, you see. Like that. They're all happy again. They'll be fine. We've got floating boats. We've got a floating boat alert. Oh, no. It just looks like it's floating. It's floating. Only in shadow. We've got sound problems there where you're going to have to put up with that, guys. I'm sorry, you're going to have to put up with all that sound. How is our university campus doing? Nearly the end of the academic year. Need more students, need more academic... Oh, need more students, don't we? We've got enough places for them to live. Not enough students full stop, though, by the looks of things. So we need to increase our residential. Which, to be fair, we could do relatively easy here, couldn't we? We could just do a... Could just do something like that, and that's another 3 billion. I think you need to make... I think you need more people who then make students. Yes, that's right. And we need more children's services, so we increase the birth rate. So we need a children's services unit here somewhere, in this part of the area. I'm not sure where we're going to put it, though. We could put it there, next to the metro station. Child health centre. Small healthcare facility increases birth rate within the building's radius and offers health services to children and teens with a health benefit. What's... Look at that big old area we're going to have more babies in. I could even put it just there, look. There we go. Nobody seems... Oh, fire, fire! The schools at the... Sorry, the Centre for Creative Arts is on fire! Fire, fire! Infamy! Sorry. All those lovely trees we planted are now on fire. It's fine. Academic year report. 310 students. 440. A campus attractiveness. We won a sports trophy for swimming. And we've got... Oh, we've had two toga parties. We've always got toga parties. You have to wear two togas, though. That's why it's called a two-toga party. So, as you can see, we're now starting to expand our... Wrong button. We're expanding our district here slightly. Might have to expand down here next to the poo treatment works. Do a few little corner shops there. And we'll expand our riverside housing. Any kids using Lake Park Park today? Well, there's a few families there by the looks of it, enjoying the sunshine when they should indeed be locked down. It is fine, perfectly fine. Oh, fire! Fire! Where's the fire engines? Fire! Is that them there? There they are. Look, they're on their... Which fire are they on their way to? Are they on their way to the fire at Lake Park or the fire at the school? Looks like they're on their way to the fire at the school. We need, therefore, a new massive, mahoosive fire station. Mega Hoosive Fire Station. That one. I'm going to build its own little place for it to go. No, that's not going to work, is it? Uh, Oh, screw it. We're just going to put it there. We're just going to put it there. We have got fire. We've got, look, helicopters. Fire, fire. Send the fire engines. There's one fire engine in use. What? Look at all these fires. Why is there no... There's another fire engine. Look. It's fine. We're getting there slowly. As the heli choppers are chopping the heli and dumping water on the buildings. Tempted to put the little bits down here, actually. I can't put a ferry terminal in there, I don't think. Don't think it's going to be any use to that. What have we got up here? What are the problems up here? Citizens are sick. Noise pollution. I don't think we're going to get away with that without taking away the commercial districts, which are a little bit... You would find shops in a built-up area like that, you see. So I'm not really prepared to take them out. They'll have to pull up with it. They will have to put up with it. Look, these people aren't complaining about this motorway junction here, especially with all these cars and stuff. What I'm going to do is I'm going to extend some of our generic industrial stuff here. Not sure why I've not filled those colours in as well, but we've done it now, so that's fine. Right, so we'll let that. We'll put a bit more industry in there. How is the agriculture area doing? Reasonably fully staffed, which is good. Making animal products, which is good as well. That will work out for our overall profit. The mineral industry is pretty redundant now. So it's a couple more workers and then some more resources. So what I'll do is put some more cattle fields. Because we don't need fertile land for the cattle, do we? Or do we? I don't think we do, but I think it's just for the crops, the fertile land, isn't it? That's fine. We'll find out the hard way. Can we put it there? Let us put it there. It's fine. So we'll do some more of that there. And we'll put some buildings there. We'll put some low density housing there, right on the edge of the high density housing estate. It'll be fine. Oh, packaging. That's a auto save, isn't it? There we go. Pernu is Italian for jean jacket. We take the second best. So what we've done, essentially, just because you don't have taste. What we've done is extended out our VIP area, and hopefully none of the people that are just on the outside of the VIP area will notice, so that they don't get VIP treatment, but they do indeed get the VIP name. Riding a bike, painting, eating a sandwich. The city has a lot to offer. So what do you do while you listen to City's radio? What can we do up there? Can we do... where would I extend next? I'd extend the Polytechnic out there, but we don't need that yet. Shake hands with a turtle. At the City Zoo, you can experience the... Why would you shake hands with a turtle? It's going to bite your hand off. ...to meet our newest addition, a three-toed sloth named Barbara. She'll hook you with her smile and hook you again with her curved toes used to grasp trees in the wild. After that, take a gander at another new species. A new type of bird previously identified as a different type of bird. It's a new type of bird that was previously identified as a chicken.
Book now and get a free handful of
Peloton. All right, I should rewrite these adverts.
Limit four per family while supplies last. We'll look forward to
why have they not put in any adverts about lockdown? That's what I want to know. In this time of need, everyone listening to Cities Radio needs to ensure that they remain no more than 2.5 meters from the nearest person. That includes while you are in bed. You think they should be disabled in the playlist? You gotta have some humour with them. They've gotta be slightly funny now. The ones that we've got aren't really any humour for me anymore. I get such a this feels so deja vu. It really does. I don't know why. No, we should do all the adverts again. It'd be like, come to Hollywood Bowl Bowling Alley. Well, we would like you to come to Hollywood Bowling Alley. The government has told us to shut down. Join us again soon when we will give you a free pitcher of Coors Light for every game of bowling that you have. Please drink responsibly and not like you've been doing for the last 3 months of lockdown. That sort of thing. And I know. I'm sorry for those of you thinking, what the blithering hell is he on about? Actually, no, I don't want that there. I don't want that. It is possible to mod a playlist, you're right. It's also possible to have your own playlists, isn't it? Or was that Surviving Mars that Cringer did his own playlist? I can't remember. It was one or the other. How are we doing with education? We are going to be in need of a new school. So we're going to put a community school right up here. Oh, no water. Sorry. There we go. I have water. I got one. Come to Wetherspoons. No, don't come to Wetherspoons. We're closed. At your local Fuller's Bar now. Half price takeaway bottles of beer. Bring an old milk carton and we'll fill it up from the tap as well. Draft beer in an old milk carton. It's 4 pints for £10. See, I do things like that and I scare people away. I don't know who you were, the viewer, who's now disappeared, but thank you for joining us for that 5 minutes of absolute chaos. Let's put, we need to put another high school in. We'll put it there, look. That's a good point to put at a school. It's a bit close to the ship pipe to really be useful for housing, so we'll put a school there instead. Just outside. There we go. Have some water. Actually, that doesn't look too bad. We've got the old railway line there and the old abandoned mine. I hope it's abandoned. I hope they're not still doing it. Otherwise, we're in trouble. And some housing there. Some high density housing there. Might put a town centre the other side of this metro station, actually. Do sort of leisure and tourism. Leisure mainly. So I could do it there, look. And put our snapping back on so that we can snap it. Snap it to me, baby. Snap it to me, baby. Oh, no, we've all gone. Slim's live. I wondered why it was so busy in here. So what we'll do is we'll do sort of a high streety, towny sort of districty sort of here. It's all, I bet it's all within. Oh no, that's cool, that's fine. That is fine. So we'll make this a shopping leisure district. Can't make it, we can't do it all, yeah. That's a shame, because it's all gonna be, oh, we've merged it in, have we? Okay. So we have to make two. Oh, congratulations! Beechwood Agricultural Area has reached level 3. Level 3 suits you, sir. We'll go and have a look at that in the very, very short while. We'll map first. First, I want to do this. So that's going to be our leisure district there. That's going to be standard shopping district. They're going to have the same policies, though. We'll be a small business enthusiast. We'll encourage high street shopping. Not really a lot we can do there. Encourage recycling, pet ban, because it's like a, it's shops. You don't want pets in shops, do you? Wait, you might do. So in Coleridge Park, we'll go for the same pet ban, recycling, and small business enthusiast. We're going to make all this small business, low density commercial. Actually, would you just block it all? There we go. That's too close. There we go. So we'll just do this. We'll just do it like this. It's fine. And then we'll do low density leisure in there. We'll do a little footpath, maybe. Can we do footpaths onto metro tracks? A foot crossing? No, don't be silly. Can't do that. Why would we want a foot crossing over a metro track? Like, really? Nah, what? Hey, silly idea. We'll do a road. Where's our bus service? Let's put the bus up there. What we'll do is we'll move the bus stops into there. We'll move the bus stops into there and there for the leisure section. And then there for the metro station. Happy days. Still not sure what to do with that. Might just leave it. So I put a footpath there, maybe. Where's our city park footpaths? Could sort of make it into a small nature reserve? That might work. Sort of have the entrance up here and just have a really, really, really small, thin strip of nature reserve. I wonder if that will work. Let's try it. Because we'll try it. It's fine. Evergreen ground. It might not work, you see. But there's no harm in trying. I might just make it a free nature reserve for families to go to, rather than one of these ones where you charge money. Like that. Where's our parks? There it is. Nature reserve. Small nature reserve gate. There we go. We'll put it there. Where's the bus stop? Just watching where this bus stops. Oh, it's up there, is it? Okay. Well, we'll put the gate there, look, then. Congratulations, level one. It's tents and campfires and nature reserve side gates and stuff. I want a side gate. I want my side gate up here. Now, the problem is we have to extend this road just a tiny, tiny bit, aren't we? Down to, like, there. And then we'll put the side gate in there. And then all the residents are complaining, but they're going to be happy again now. Look. And we'll, the first thing we'll do is we'll connect the two gates up with a footpath. Right, is that going to work? Am I going to destroy houses putting it there? Oh, it's tight. Along the waterfront there, look. And then up. Right. So, there's our path. It's not really worked the way I want it to work. But, that's fine. Well, we can work with this. And if it doesn't work, we'll just abandon it. It'll be fine. So, we'll just level this out a little bit. Oh! Fire! 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 Someone go deal with the. We've got a big fire station up here somewhere. With a bit of, you got no water. Okay. Fire! There's one fire engine. Is it coming down here?
Smashed PC sales records and took the industry by storm. Now the hit.
I can't see it. Where's the fire engine? Oh, you got no water either. Fire! Oh, here he comes. Eventually, from like the other side of the map. Fire! Fire! Right, back to no, wrong one. That one. Back to building. What I want to do is a little sort of secluded camping site here, you see? Where people can enjoy a nice, quiet, family camping trip with, like, blackjack and hookers. With their families. Campfire number one. Says the campfire. We'll put some tents around it. There's our tentage. Try and put them a little way apart because they do like to catch fire. Certainly, at the very beginning of park life, they liked to catch fire.
At Banhammer Bank, we want you to trust us with your money. Because it's with your money that we can make you more money. How? It's not funny business, it's money business. You give your money to us.
So we'll make it a nice and secluded tentage area so that people walking by can't see you doing anything you shouldn't be doing in your tent area. And what else we got here that we can do? Another campfire just there, I reckon. Like that. Now, does that mean that we've got enough entertainment? We've got enough entertainment. We just need to get some visitors in. And we'll make it a nominal fee entry for Evergreen Marsh. We'll make it a nominal entry fee just to cover immediate expenses. And look at how quickly people are coming into the nature reserve. We've only got like 5 people here. Why are you complaining about the noise? Oh, it's that. Okay, right. Let's get rid of it. Where's that going to go now? That can go up there with these. There we go. Job done. And we've still got this big area here to play with. We haven't even started out here yet. And what we got? We got any forest there? A little bit of forest, a little bit of farmland. Not really much that I'd justify putting forestry down. To be fair. Which is a shame. Just waiting for daylight to see what we can do with it. Yeah, I think the answer is not a huge amount at the moment. We've got this bit up here as well, outside of the motorway. Again, that's only a little bit of forest, which is a shame. How are we doing with the agricultural area? Fully staffed, look. There's only 60 jobs available. We haven't got enough workers yet, but we need more resources as well. So we're not in desperate need. 8% unemployment. And most people now highly educated. So we need a bit of a slummy area to keep the unskilled workers working as well. No idea where I'm going to put that. Like, we could put it in here, couldn't we? And sort of go for no high rise, but high density. I wonder how that will look. I wonder if they've changed that. No. Right. They can have their own metro station as well, look. If we plan it right. Lafayette Hills. That sounds very high density, low education, doesn't it? Lafayette Hills. Schools out, which is citizen preferred work and over education. Recreational use. Allows recreational use of controlled substances. Yup. Not really anything else there that would go for a high-rise ban. NIMBY? No, not NIMBY. Workers' Union. Residential tax income drops by 2%, slightly increase adult citizens' happiness. Well, as they're going straight into industry, that might work for us, I think. Oh, I'm trying to get rid of it. There we go. Thank you. So what we'll do is we'll do our road. I think that will be about right to put our metro station in. Sort of. It's close enough. It's close enough for me to say I'm happy there. And then we just need to get rid of a bit more track so that we can connect it up. Like that. And like that. And actually, that road would probably then go to our leisure district. Out to the main dual carriageway. Out to our abandoned something. And because we're looking for just high density stuff. Have I just destroyed the... Oh, didn't I do that? Oh, well. Oh, well. So let's just have a look at our area. So we're going to bring our area now down to here. Apparently I've just left the house. If you say so, game, phone, if you say so. You have now left the house. So we're going into eco mode. No, we're not. No, we're not. We are here. So this is going to be our residential area. This is the road out. We'll not worry about putting any high density there because of the metro station. Actually, we'll get the metro stopping at the metro station. That would help, wouldn't it? There we go. It's actually quite near to the other metro station, so it probably wouldn't really have mattered too much. And let's just go for fill it in. Fill it in. See what we get. See what we get from that. Oh, don't want that then. Don't want that then. See what sort of buildings we get. We've got a building. A building? Really? Oh, where's my post office? We could move that, couldn't we? Where's the... Oh, it's over there, isn't it? Is that it? Yeah, we'll move that over to here, look. Should still cover the most of them. Yeah, that still covers most of them. Do 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 do. So yeah, not very high rise, which is fine. Happy with that. And they'll hopefully go and work in the fields. Maybe. And we'll put some fields in there. And we'll put our last couple of fields for that bit in. It's not gonna go, is it, in there? No, not gonna go. That's fine. That's fine. We're fine. We're happy with that. And we haven't got things like a bakery yet either, which is crazy, because we really should be doing that to make more profit, shouldn't we? So if we extend our industry area out here, because you don't need fertile land for a bakery, do you? You need fertile land to make lemonade. Lemonade, I say. Lemonade! Flour mill. Turns crops into flour, not surprisingly. Milking parlour. Process bill needs to be placed inside the industry area. Requires crops to produce farming special good. Well, isn't that what we've got animals for? No? Is that not what we've got it for? No, not warehouses. Unique buildings. Thank you. Industrial steel plant. We never got round to using that. Bakery. We'll leave that for now. We got the flour mill going, so we'll build some flour out of it. Or create some flour out of it. We've got flour warehouse there. Not really. We can fiddle with that later on. That's fine. It's perfectly fine. Oh, where's my Amazon? That's a good point. Where's my Amazon? Don't know why that made me think of Amazon. We were saying that he was 8 stops away. Haven't heard the door go yet. Oh, apparently it is delivered. Excellent. And it was apparently handed to me. Even better. Want to be famous? No, not really. Don't really want to be famous. Dooby 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 doob doob. Bye bye. Bye bye. Yeah, I could report him, couldn't I? Trying to find. No, can't see a report button from that screen there. Oh well, it's fine. He's banned. He's gone. That's the new Mega Banhammer, isn't it? The Mega Banhammer, that's not really that much of a mega, nor a hammer. But it does ban, so we're fine there. How's the city coming along? Disabled One, good afternoon. I hope you're doing well. Yeah, we're getting there. We're getting there. We are now up to 19,000. So we're still working on vanilla. We were talking about bringing mods in a few dozen hours' time, maybe, to tidy up the worst bits of it. So we're building up around here quite a lot at the moment. Morning Falls 311. Yeah, I'll play around with the settings later, Sabiko. We know who it is. We can report them. That's fine. I've banned them from the channel for now to shut them up, so. Now, how are we getting on here? We got plenty of housing here. They're all fully occupied, which is good. Less happy up there. Is that not... That is part of the no high-rise area. That is part of the no high-rise area. That's a little bit high-rise for my high-rise liking. Oh, well. It's fine. They're hopefully going to go and work in the fields. How's our unemployment doing? 9%. 8%. It'll be fine. How is our Evergreen Marsh doing? That's an important one. Let's come out of that view there. This is... Where is it? There it is. This is our miniature cheap nature reserve. Got enough entertainment. We're just waiting on the visitor numbers. You're just about to play City Skylines yourself, continuing on your two countries map. Excellent. I hope you do well with your two countries map. It's been a while since I've played this, so we're getting there slowly. Just thinking, how much can I push that in there? Actually, that pushes in quite well. Two countries, fictional map. One half is your country and the other is a different country. We're working on both. Oh, right. Okay. So, sort of like you would hope to use intercity buses that you can't use, sort of thing. Because it's like two mayorships and... Yeah, sounds cool. I like that idea, and seeing some other streamers getting involved in sort of like multiplayer. I won't profess to know how they do it, so it's not something that would interest me in terms of the way that I play, but I could see how something like that would work pretty well. Electricity interconnectors. Good. Right, so we're going to put some more nature reservey stuff. Actually, could use some of the... Hey, academic year report. Still unrecognized, though. Student increasing, campus attractiveness decreasing. That's a shame. We need to make more babies in this game so that they can go to university. So what I was thinking of doing here was sort of like gazebo-y, music-y. So I'd use the floor tiles from the nature reserve. Currently 3 motorways on your side. But you're developing both sides, aren't you? That's the way I understood what you were saying. Not based on UK motorways. No, now, I must admit, I don't do that on here. But when I play Transport Fever 2, at the moment, I've got a map on the go for Portsmouth and Southampton. And I'm vaguely building the motorways there. So the M27, the A27, the M3. Or trying to, anyway. Can you name roads? What, in City Skylines? Yeah, you can name roads. Or are you talking about in Transport Fever 2? In TF2? No, you can't. No. No. You can only imagine the names on them. So what we're going to do is we're going to put a little picnic area in here. M1 runs from the southwest to the map to the centre of the coast. Okay. Sounds like a good little map. Evergreen Marsh, level 2. We've got some tent camping sites. Which, no, I want that one, actually. And the M1's coastal. Well, it's definitely not true to life, then. The M1 goes nowhere near the coast. I'll put a sandpit down for the kiddiewinks to play in. EuroPC tried to make a map with the terraced mountain all the way down to the coast. Never really got to work. Yeah, I've never even attempted to build maps. That's just, it's just nowhere near what I'd want to do. Try and get this lined up nicely. One of the rare moments of concentration. M4 branches off in the southwest to crossing to the next country. Ah, but surely the M1 should be the primary motorway that would take you across to the next country. Now I'm gonna try and put some flower beds then. That's not gonna work.
Our animatronics are so real. I might have let up. There we go. There we go. Right on the edge there. That a brontosaurus is serving you chili dogs. Every dish is an archaeological find. Might have to move these benches up a bit, though, which is a bit of a shame. It means you've got to destroy them and rebuild them. Ah, no! Take a trip into the wild at Dinosaurus. You can dine in or... Ah, no! I really like being a radio host. Oh, I've got to do all that again. Come on, alright, we'll leave that bench there then. That's fine. So, I've got to try and align this now. Like that. There we go. Proud to present a box on both your houses. The untold story of the invention of the box and the family rivalry that nearly destroyed it. It's a tale about opening your heart. Oh, pardon me. Pardon me. Where were we? The most efficient means of shipping and bumpy motorway due to... Yeah. Proving that to find what's in your soul. Due to go through the Blue Mountains and the Perseus Mountains. And lorries are nearly a majority on the M1. So your main thoroughfare on that sounds like it is... aimed at lorries then. You're not... I take it you've got lots of... Is that going to go there? I take it you've got lots of, what's the word? Public transport between the two cities then, if it's majority lorries, by the sounds of it. Now, where are we going to put this next camping area? It's going to have to go there, isn't it? It's going to get extended. Ah. No, that's not looking right at all. I'd have to lower all that land, wouldn't I? Or is it done? No! Yeah, it's done it all right, but it's taken my footpath. No! Naughty game. 1 mile extension. Construction of the M3. That's a good idea, but surely you would have numbering wouldn't be that sequential because you've got multiple motorways being built in multiple areas all the time. We're about to lose the sand pit. Sand pit's gone. We have to move the sand pit over. Well, we've still got to build this area, to be fair. There's not going to be as much seclusion for these tents, as you may have noticed. They're not going to be able to get up any funny business like our first tenting section. Close at least two roads for construction. Anything else is unrealistic. Well, no. What we should do is have your four core motorways to start with. So M1, M2, M3, M4. Then have or even M1, M2. So if you have an offshoot from the M2, it's the M21. If you have an offshoot from the M1, it's the M11. If you have an offshoot from the M4, That's how I would do it. But then that two countries is not my map, so everyone is free to do their own map in their own way. Right, so put the sand pit there then. It'll be fine. Have we done enough to get the next level in terms of entertainment? We have, so we'll leave that to it. Oh, you got no water up there. Oh, sorry. Come on, have some water. Have some water. You can open your taps now and it'll be pure beer. Western coastline fairly flat, eastern coastline for the mountains.
sounds interesting. Does sound interesting. And we've still got this bleeding queue of trams. To be fair, if that's a line one and a line two, yeah, so it's just the two lines and their convergence now, which is useful. Because it means that people won't be hanging around the stops too much to interchange if they need to. How are we getting on with the tram up here? Many people on it? Many people waiting for it? No one on it, which is understandable. They want to get off one side of Oliver Street to go to work and they'll return on the other side. 15 on board, okay. That's fine. So we'll leave that for now. I prefer this section of low rise, high density to this one. Don't like this. Don't know why. I'm going to leave it. I'm going to have to leave it. Because it will just demolish everything, won't it? I'm going to stick to the no high rise in high density, I think. How are we doing up here in Summit Square? There shouldn't be any residents, that's right. We are fully staffed, 152 workers out of 154. And one why would a tourist want to go there? Why would we have a tourist? Why a tourist? Although being an IT cluster, clearly business is booming in electric cars. The Edison Hypercharger operating normally and fully staffed. Happy with that. What I'm not happy with though, what was that? Did I see an abandonment? No? Okay. What I'm not happy with though is my education district, my academia. Because we're not getting enough students, frankly. We've got the attractiveness, we're getting the students, we've got as much investment as we can. We'll go for an IT and engineering grant. That might get us our academic work, which will get us to the next level. We just need some more students. Something just doesn't gel right for me in this. Like, we got dormitories available for they're basically getting a whole section of the dormitory each. It's not mixed hostel conditions where you got tent or room. They've got a room each by the looks of it. There's a 38 in that dormitory. You had to add like 8 elementaries. Really? What have I got? Elementaries. I've got capacity for 2,000, eligible 1,500. So most of my citizens are not educated. We've got enough capacity for high school, masses of capacity for university, and of course our generic public library. We want to put another public library in, I reckon. There. So if we put a public library, how much room have we got? Not a lot. I want to leave this bit here. Yeah, I haven't left enough room there for it. There's one there already. Could put one up here, couldn't we? Because this is just generic residential. So I could get rid of that road. That's our groundskeeping. From the trade school, so we can put that anywhere we want. Really, we can put it there and then put a public library there to educate this high density residential area. Education's bad for you as well, is it? Ah.
That's all running well. The good thing is we haven't got many complaints from our residents. You get the occasional blip where somebody's not well. But we've now got to look at where we're going to build our next big residential commercial areas, because we're now running out of space in the areas that we are in. So, not going to do it behind the industrial area there. This island here could be like a peninsula, sort of Portsmouth, Gosport sort of area for those in the UK, sort of isolated off. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, do check out my Transport Fever 2 videos, where we have been doing work on Portsmouth and Gosport and Southampton. Wondering if we do it here. Actually, that would be quite good, not for residential, but for sort of another nature reserve. It's probably not a good idea to extend this nature reserve right the way out to here. That's not going to work. Could turn it into a zoo, couldn't we? We haven't got a zoo yet. Quite why it's popping up leisure, though. Just let me build my zoo game. Don't taunt me. Sort of a bit like Marwell, really. It's in the middle of nowhere. You have to go by car or bus to get to it. Life is Feudal. I've got it. I have got it in my Steam library. Never really got around to playing it. It was one of those games where I think it came up free on Steam or somewhere for a short time. Picked it up. It's an MMO, isn't it? Everyone seems to be suggesting MMOs to me at the moment. Oh, I'm not thinking of that then. What was I doing? Ah, yes, building my zoo. So we'll put our little bus stop in. Don't like that. Don't like that either. I'm starting it a bit too far back, aren't I? There we go. There we go, and there will be the entrance to our zoo. There's three different versions, is there? Okay. Sunnyside Zoological Gardens has reached level 1. The only reason why I'm thinking this might make a good zoo area, well, I was going to go for nature reserves, is the ruins here. We don't want to remove the ruins, though. We've got to be careful. Don't want to remove the ruins, psycho. Don't be a silly psycho. Make sure you don't destroy the ruins. An MMO as a single player. But like I say, I've never really looked at it. I got it and I was like, oh, I'll have a look at that, and never got round to it. So maybe I will have to have a look at it someday. Right. There's our first elements. So, first important thing to do is put in some toilets. Moose and reindeer. It's a bit tropical for moose, for reindeer anyway. Antelope. Where are we going to put the antelope? Right there. Don't forget the toilet paper. That's absolutely true. I've got enough toilet paper though. I'm fine. I've got enough to keep me going. Fencing there. Fencing. Footpaths there so people can... No, that doesn't work. No, it doesn't work. I need it up the same height game. Same height game. Come on, game. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, I can't do that one anymore, can I? Keep forgetting I can't say that anymore. That's banned. Even our poo can't say it now. Disappointingly. That's better. Right, so. Obviously, we need to make sure. That none of our delightful visitors fall down the cliff and into the water. So we've got to put this. We've got to put this up like so. As we got the follow from KMCat88, welcome along. I'm sorry, I didn't spot you going in there and hitting the follow button. That ping from my phone told me that you'd followed. And that's fine, but it shouldn't have pinged. I put it on silent earlier. Anyway, right, so we have got... we got a little sewage problem starting to manifest. So we'll do our own... we haven't actually. We've got this. We can do that. There we go. Turn that on. Turn on the poo pipe.
At Banhammer Bank, we want you to trust us with your money. Because it's
and then
money
over
that we can
to there.
How? It's not funny business. It's
the only that's the only downside as all the waiting and Dawn of Man, very casual, lots of waiting.
Maybe that's too complicated for you. Imagine planting a money tree in the ground and watering it.
Yeah, I must admit, I do remember someone saying that before when we did a review of... Somebody was reviewing down Dawn of Man and talking to me about it, and I was like, doesn't sound like something that I'd do. He said, yeah, it's very quiet.
To avoid saying what we really do with your money. Banhammer Bank, feed the
but,
money monster.
I've got enough games to keep me going at the moment, though.
As I go around the city, I see people doing so many interesting things.
And I may be ending up going back into an old job role for a couple of weeks due to the outbreak. Or rather, I offered. Whether they'll accept my offer, who knows? Cafe, is that cafe? Yeah, cafe, souvenir shop, antelope enclosure.
You'll break box office records of fun as you take a trip to Tinseltown, Movieville, USA.
Still not. Oh, birdhouse. There we go. We'll do a birdhouse.
Guaranteeing the only thing you hear is the movie. That high-pitched shuttle drone is
normal. Have a birdhouse. Mooses, not mooses. Antelopes and birds. That's all you need to run a zoo, apparently.
Hey, listeners, you're tuning
and toilets. With toilet paper. We'll put a cafe there opposite the toilet so that people can have something to eat. We'll put some seating and feeding areas in. Look, we can do that there, look. Don't like that. All right, we'll leave it like that then. That's fine. We'll leave it like that. And we'll just put some benches in for them to sit down and enjoy. We'll do a zoo information board for people to read. I don't think they do now, do they? I think they just have mobile phone apps. Didn't really need to put the title up, did I, Sabiko? We know it's Viking metal, Viking gods. Now, we need to get a bus service down there. Where's my bus? Bus. Bus stop. And we're just going to run the bus service down to the metro station. Because we don't want another bus service running all the way through town, do we? Might do, but I don't want to. And then we'll run it down to the ferry. So we'll get stopping in the town centre there in case any of the locals want to go to the zoo. I'll just have it following the normal bus stop route. There we go. And then back out there. Happy days. M1 extension is now complete. Congratulations, Force. I would offer you a Steam achievement for that, but I'm fresh out, I'm afraid. No, seriously. Yeah. I love just getting in depth with the game and just losing 4 hours a day, like we do generally here. What have you got there? We've got nothing there. Let's have a look at the industry area. What we got? What we got to do? We need more workers. And how are we looking for crops? Full for crops. So we need to use our crops up. Milking parlor crops into meat. We'll take that. We'll take that. That's fine. Where can we put it? There. There we go. We'll put one there. We'll see how that works. They'll immediately complain that they haven't got enough crops and enough workers. So. What I would do once we think about. Traffic flow 82%. Where's the problems? What? Hey, what? Why have I got that screen? This is a traffic flow problem, which we have to fix using TMPE. So we won't do that right now. We'll leave that until we start modding in about 20 game hours time. I got water, so I'm gonna have to put some more housing in, aren't we? Where am I going to put more housing in? I'm looking up here. I'm thinking, don't put it there because of all of those. We could move that wind turbine. We can't move that wind turbine. We could leave that wind turbine right there then. And then we can put maybe housing up here somewhere. Or do I just put a whole new town here? I'd like to have intercity coaches of my own. This is one of the things that I don't like about the new DLC. They've got the intercity coaches that work in the same way as intercity trains. So you don't actually get to use and abuse them. They have to come from inside the outside the city or come into the city to make a service, but it'd be really good to be able to use our own and make use of the intercity coach model, like we've got the school bus. But you already had local buses. What would be the difference? Access to the model.
personally, Sabiko, I think that the school buses should, if selected, focus on the schools. No, I think you go further than that. I think, for example, the school buses should use predominantly the schools, so it would carry more students, and you'd set that up to terminate or call it a school, an educational area, so in the campus or outside a school. And if you had created the route connected to a school, it would give you the opportunity. You got a school bus model in this now. These aren't. I think it's in here. So you can use a school bus model. But I reckon if you use a school bus model and connect it to a school, it would predominantly carry students, which would work better if we use real time. And it was configured so that the schools were only open during the day, because then, as you've seen me do in previous builds, I would run the buses to the schools at the school times using real time. And the universities, congratulations, Beechwood has leveled up, level 4. We can make a clothing factory, and indeed we can kill our animals. So what do we need? We need another 250 workers, although to be fair, we only need another 150, 180 vacancies. So I think we need to build our residential up first. How close are we to our next... Oh, we're nowhere near. We're not that far beyond the Grand City, to be fair. And we didn't even start looking at the waste processing complex. That's going to be quite a messy, dirty, smelly... Oh, that's awful. We're going to have to place this right out in the middle of nowhere, aren't we? That's big and bad. Would we do that up here on the hills? Probably not. It's probably something I'll have to put sort of here. We do need it, though. I could put it right in there, couldn't I? Don't want anyone parking up near it. Don't want random cars parking on the road, do we? So let's see if we can... do that. And then we'll put it right up there. Can't build on water. Already occupied. Really? Yeah. Is it just too big? And that must be placed roadside. That's what I'm trying to do. Wonder if that will work. Does sort of. Don't particularly like that. I don't think I might have to get some move it out. Is it going to need power? It needs water as well, does it? Oh dear. It's going to need its own separate supply, isn't it, really? Can't really chuck it all the way into... Must be placed roadside. What? No, that's not what I was looking for, actually. That's what I was looking for.
that. Is that going to be enough power for it all? That's the question. Or am I going to need a second wind turbine? I think I might need a second wind turbine. That's fine.
I guess then I agree with that you can't just set these buses to the intercity. Yeah. Well, I wouldn't trolley model. No, you've got to connect the trolley model up, haven't you? You've got to connect it to wires. That would make sense that you would set it as a separate trolley bus route, because trolley bus stops and normal bus stops can't use the same section of road. Which, I think is quite odd. Personally. But combine it with real time. Why you can't designate school services, because then people can model and asset new school buses and asset specific intercity coaches. I don't know if you remember back to one of my earliest city builds modded, where we had a load of coaches running around and specifying those for intercity routes, and then having an, say, intercity coach terminal there, our existing intercity coach station there, which we can still run normal buses into, but that's beside the point. And then maybe another one out here or out here or up there, an alternative to trains. And make it a more premium product. What's your problem? Not enough crops. But we've got 300 tons of crops there. We've got 300 tons of crops. We've got 1,200 tons of crops. How can you not have enough crops? How? That's fine. I'll put some more crop in. Not enough money. City Skylines industry. But the thing is, for what it developed in terms of adding to the game, actually, I think that Industries is one of the better DLCs. Italian leather. In my opinion, anyway. And my opinion is the only one that counts right now. We take the second best of Milan. And with an appropriate markup, bring it to you. It
hasn't been successfully implemented, you're right. The content is great, but it doesn't work the way that I would like it to work. Prime example, oil wells don't necessarily feed oil power plants first. Whether they could introduce an oil refinery to take that oil coming up from the well into oil for the power plant, that could be an additional part of the DLC, whether that's introduced as a free update to the DLC at a future point in time, or whether indeed it's something that we could put into City Skylines 2, which clearly, after 5 years, must be on the drawing board somewhere. Maybe. You'd hope so. Look at Transport Fever 2. Completely different game to Transport Fever 1 for a large part of it. It's a free market. Your power plants just can't pay market prices. No, my power plants just don't receive oil. To be fair, that oil power plant hasn't had any complaints today yet, has it? There's no trucks heading towards it, but the problem that we had yesterday with it just not receiving oil hasn't, well, certainly that I've seen, hasn't happened. How are we doing over here? Are they Lafayette Hills, are they happy? So you've got almost full housing, you've got full
commercial, you got workers, everything's full. Usually the complaints about the TF series is that the game is not completely different, but instead of a kind of 1.5. It's... the mechanics are the same, I grant that. The changes to the industry and the fact you now need two raw material to process at the very start of things, so that the fuel line processing two crude into one oil to then process on into fuel. Yes, it feels like a different game though. It really does to me. How are we doing up here? They actually, they're whacking through. They're 10 million capacity. They're already at 500,000. So they've got a little way to go, but wonder if they can call up the cemeteries and pick up the bodies as well. Do we reckon they can do that? That doesn't crash more than TF1. I'm sorry, Sabika. I'm not getting crashes as long as I don't go away from the main window when it's loading a save game. How are we getting up here? See, traffic's flowing a little better here now. Now that we've removed these roads in this little estate. We've got a little bit of a problem here still. I think. I'm not making fun of it, Sabiko. What I'm saying is, I don't seem to have the same problems that you do. That's all I'm saying. I don't profess to know why you have those problems either. Right, I'm going to sort these I know how to sort these trams out. I know how to sort these trams out. You're saying my problems are irrelevant. No, they're not irrelevant to me. I was helping you to fix them. How would that not be relevant? If you want to talk about relevance, you do the part-time bit of work that I've been doing recently, where it talks about advert relevance and things. An advert that shows like pretty ladies and things, and then all of a sudden it's actually an advert for Bowman keto diet drinks that have nothing to do with the Bowman video that you've just been watching. That's relevance. It's not gonna work. I can't move that anymore either. I'm gonna have to do the road, aren't I? I'm gonna have to move the road. This isn't gonna go well. Not even gonna let me do it. Oh no. So I've got to get rid of that road as well then. I've got to extend that down. Is it not going to let me even go that way? Oh, pants. Academic year report. We've lost students. We've gained attractiveness and we're still unrecognised. But we've got our two academic works, including anti-gravity drones. Do that down to there then. Will that now... No, that still sees that node. Bye-bye! That's fine.
So what we will do, we will bring it right the way out there. Like that. Then we'll put in this new tram road thing. You got loud cheering. That does sound like me, doesn't it? It's, oh yeah, it's there. All right, okay. Yeah, that is a bit loud, isn't it? Why is that so loud? Did we not fiddle with the audio last time? Effects, no. There we go. There we go. Yeah, it's because we were fiddling with some of the sound, weren't we, yesterday? You didn't like the sound settings yesterday. Clearly, I didn't change all the sound settings properly. So, we are going to... I mean, slope's too steep. Only 9U game. It's only 9U game. Why are you being so hard work for me today? I don't like that now. What can I say? I want my stream to sound like a one-tone mush of indistinguishable background boredom. Absolutely, Savico. I couldn't agree more. That's just going to have to be a two-way road, isn't it? Oh, that's a shame. That's a shame. Right, so we've now got to move our tram to go up there. Up there. There and there. And then we'll do a footpath across. We'll wait for the trams to clear out the way. Then we'll get rid of the dual carriageway. We'll reset the dual carriageway with a better incline. And everyone will be happy, apart from Sabiko. Why have you got no power? Probably because you're not connected to a power source. There we go. And because we kind of... And because we kind of just got rid of all the commercial around here, didn't we? That was no, don't want that now. Do I want that now? Do I want that now? Do I want that now? Or can I just run the tram all the way down here? Can run the tram down to here and go somewhere. No idea. No idea. So I'm getting rid of that road. Could do with having the tram down here, couldn't we? Look at all these cars that we want to get rid of. The question is, how would I get it back? So I could do that. The question then is, how would I get it back up to there? I'd probably have to use where we've got all this lovely tree.
Shadows fall.
So we'd have to have it sorted. Because it would then eliminate this bridge, wouldn't it, if we did that? We're not going to be losing any... Do we need it on the road at all? That's the question. How easy would I be able to get it up to there? What I'm thinking is run the tram here, swinging it around, and then once, as this is now up, trying to get it up to there. I don't think I've got enough room for that. Hi, seriously? I don't think I've got enough room for that. Which is a shame. I could extend the whole roundabout out, but I don't think. Like, look at all these people leaving now. Sunnyside Zoological Gardens reaches level 2. We can do insects, amphibians, and reptiles and bison. Why don't we put the insect, amphibian, and reptiles in with the bison? Wouldn't that make more sense? Like, look at all these people now that this is finished. This is just crazy. This is what's causing the problem. So... I don't want to have all the trams double backing on each other here. That's definitely not what I want to happen. I could, of course. Look at all these people looking for trams now. There, look. Right. Yeah. What we're going to do, we're going to bring it out here like this. So put snapping back on. To donate a bird bath to 30 birdies. You can either be part of the problem or you can be with us, the Forest Foundation.
Haven't you been hearing more about disasters lately? I'm not sure.
I know what we're going to do.
I feel like meteors and sinkholes just didn't happen as much when I was younger. Maybe I just
wasn't. I sort of know what I'm going to do. I'm not sure how we're going to achieve it.
Disappeared. It was there one day, then gone the next. The weird thing was, nobody seemed to want to talk about it. Maybe it was too scary. Actually, if things can just disappear randomly, maybe I can disappear. That is scary.
Get rid of that road. Ease out the tram so it actually comes along here, stops here, and then swing it up so it joins... joins the dual carriageway sort of here, and I can do what I wanted to do originally, which was separate off ramps for the tram here.
Okay, easy boy.
They'll play your favorite hits, give out great prizes, and laugh their way.
There's logic to it. I'm not sure where the logic is, but there is logic to it.
Stable entertainment only on Cities Radio.
Dinosaurus, the only restaurant with the servers are dinosaurs.
Let's move that down there just for now. They are going to love us, those customers. No, not a new line. Track.
It's an archaeological find, like our Stegogeti, our Raptor Burger Rex, or the pile of crumbled...
And then we can tidy this up once we've done the rerouting.
So take a trip into the wild.
They're now going to be complaining like lemons because we're going to make them go all the way around to there.
Hey, listeners, you're tuned into Cities Radio, where we've got the best
like
music from
that.
In the world. It's actually really crazy.
Then they're going to be even more disappointed.
Anyway, we have a
lot of great music. It will look like
in between the commercials.
We are destroying their tram track, which we are, sort of. can't deny that we're not, because we are. Is it not going to let me do that? Can't do that. No. Oh. All right. We'll just upgrade you back to dual. There we go. Like that. There we go. See. Yes. See. Yes. And then we'll revert that back to normal roadage, like that. And then we'll get rid of that bit there. That's probably the newest song they've added to. Oh, is that a new one? No, that doesn't sound new to me. That doesn't sound new to me, Sabiko. What's time? 20 minutes to go, people. What can we get done in 20 minutes? Not a lot. How comes these trams are still going this way? Got two tram services, haven't we? And I turned the other one off. The viewing. That's why I've still got trams going up and down that road. That makes sense, Psycho. Well done, Psycho, you silly tit. There we go. Right. Now I can get rid of those tram roads. And then we'll upgrade those to standard road. Sort of works. Yes. Stellaris song called Faster Than Light. Yes. See, we now need TMPE so that I can manually fiddle with these. Because obviously. Oh, we can put these two sets of lights and time them together, you see. So certain trams can go at certain times and yeah. Yeah. This is very quickly becoming a possible request that we go to modded mode. I'm not going to do it. I promise. I'm not going to mods yet. Anyway, we've completely forgotten all about our zoological gardens, which leveled up for us while we were so busy doing tramage. And Sunnyside Zoological Gardens actually did level up as we did see the splash screen to level number 2, which gives us some new things to play with, and we've got enough entertainment actually to get us to level 3. But we're going to put some more entertainment in because we've got some new things to play with. Synthetic radio. No, this is Cities Radio. I didn't purchase the synthetic radio channel. To be fair, I've not seen a huge benefit to paying out £4 per radio station to find that I can't actually use some of it on recordings and various things because of the requirements of licensing. So I don't. Yeah, no, I don't go that far. I'm happy playing in-game music as long as it doesn't. Oh, what do you... Yeah, okay, right. Can't do that then. I've got antelope already. Where's the reindeer? Moose and reindeer. Moose and reindeer. Why? Slope too steep. Okay. Might have to move that at some point then. We'll leave that as it is. Sunnyside Zoological Gardens are happy. What about our nature reserve? Evergreen Marsh. Getting there. Yeah, Stellaris is a great game. It is a great game. I enjoy watching it. Don't enjoy... Well, I do enjoy trying to play it. I enjoy watching it, and there is some really funky stuff on there. I really should. And Sabiko will probably laugh at this, but I don't try to play 4X on stream anywhere near enough. I've tried Hearts of Iron. I want to play Stellaris Hearts of Iron 4. The other one in my collection. CK. CK2. I might have to wait for CK3 now. But, oh, viewing... We haven't done any viewing decks yet. We can do it. Viewing decks are easy. What do you mean can't build a viewing deck on water? That's what it's bleeding there for. Can't do viewing decks on water. What's the... CK2 is great. I like watching people playing CK2. I've just never got around to playing it. I've got it. I think the mistake I made with CK2 is I bought it as a bundle. So rather than starting with the base game, as many people did, I've got like 6 million bajillion gazillion DLCs installed, which kind of confuses me at times. I'm easily confused. Isn't there any? I'll have to put. I'll have to go into from a not that one. No, City Zoo. I'll have to put one of these in then. CK3 is easy once you find out which buttons to ignore mostly. You're playing CK3 then, are you, Sabiko? Right, how are we getting on up there? They seem full enough. I thought you were letting us our secret there, Sabiko, that you're already playing CK3 beta or something. I'm sure the likes of Cringer are. I'm sure they've already got their early access keys. Bless them. Right, so... That all looks like it's flowing nicely now. No complaints. No work. Need more workers. So need more residential nearby, don't we? Might be able. What? How big's that though? How big's the pollution in that? Not very. It's more sound than anything. Like, I suppose we could do a small bit of housing there, mainly to try and feed the agricultural area, but I don't think we've got time for that now. Like, we could do some more, we could do a little village estate-y type thing here, but again, it's not going to fit in, I don't think, with the rest of it. We've been focusing so much up here, and people are now getting sick. Noise pollution. Yeah, we haven't really got much choice. You're going to have to cope with the noise pollution, because I'm not going to change that. Campus, it's getting more students in. Have I got another university somewhere? I haven't, no. And you can't pick a building, so you can't pick a study hall. And nobody's going to the study hall. They're all already there. Like, we could get rid of this mineral industry area, because it's not really making us any money. There's a couple of power plants and things there. Well, it is making us money, but there's no ore left. There's a bit of ore there, but most of it's gone, look. All this was ore. And we got rid of it all. I'm tempted just to get rid of the ore industry. Just do that, and that, and that. These are more refusey and bus depot-y stuff. Get rid of the ore grinding mill. And then make this up into normal roads. And maybe put a nice little housing estate up here. We've already got the buses for it. A raised industry area. Buy Daffodil Land. Thanks for being a part of the city, Daffodil Land. You've now gone. What's that there? Don't know. That's a water tower. We know what that is. So what we could do, start by getting rid of all this. Put that there to keep the power up. And just make it into a little village. So we can get rid of this road in a minute. Make a little turning circle for the bus service. Is industries worth it? I think so. You know? I think industries is worth the investment. The problem is with industries is I would prefer it to have been implemented differently. Right, so we're going to extend these pylons out to there. Move that bus stop down. Yeah, exactly what Sabiko said. If it worked. I don't know whether we can say that it hasn't worked. It's offered new options into things. I wouldn't quite say it hasn't worked. I just don't think it works in the way that we wanted it to work, because a lot of us enjoy the use of the workshop. If we developed it as Fors 311 follows, and thank you indeed for that. If they developed it so that, I don't know. Oh, I don't deserve that. No, I don't deserve anything. You know what? Even more than I don't deserve it. We have to give you the disclaimer. We're morally obliged to give you the disclaimer. Don't expect to learn anything either, because it just doesn't happen. Come on, we need some extra buildings. Come on, buildings. Somebody build, somebody build. Alright, we'll do that then. What is the time? Oh, I've got 8 minutes. 8 minutes left. Let's finish off by just building up this little bit here. I'd like to say we're going to have a little village shop, but it doesn't really work like that. Again, I would like the mechanics to work slightly differently. I've always said this with City Skylines. I think that... Let's have a look. Having some houses and then having corner shops on the end like that. That's how I like to build my estate, my residential areas. I like to have like a couple of shops, maybe a little parade of shops in the middle. Like here we got a corner shop and a fish and chip shop and a kebab shop. Quite how the kebab shop makes its money, who knows? But anyway, we've got a corner shop style. We've got a kebab shop. We've got a fish and chip shop in a little parade right in the center of the estate. This game doesn't really allow for that. It causes noise complaints and things, which doesn't quite work for me. So that's why you always take when I say something's not right with a little bit of a pinch of salt, because that's the sort of thing that does salt me up a little bit. Like, a corner shop here and some houses around it shouldn't generate any noise in the grand scheme of things, but it does. So we have to accept it. Right, so we'll cut that off there so that we can put in some more. This is just gonna be a little village
we've been
type
making the
thing.
Best in mobile phones for over 20 years. How did we get there? By putting ringtones in every commercial that make you think your phone is
people cool. Complain about business noise.
No,
not as much as they do in this.
We make sure you always hear your phone.
Look, up here, always got noise complaints. Always got noise complaints. It's not realistic.
It's for you, Akio Mobile.
It's not realistic.
I really like being a radio host.
Right. So they're building up here. They build. See, they're building up here. And like, whose idea was it? Buses have to turn. Why can't buses do a three-point turn? Why can't this bus come up here, reverse into Peter Street, and then go out again? Totally unrealistic.
I was unable to play spots at the elite level I would have liked to. Instead, I invested my
energy. We digress. I'm just going to leave that like this. I'm going to close that road off there. This is just going to be a little village hamlet. I like building my village hamlets. If you've not seen me working before on these cities, you will. Well, once we get modding, we'll try and hold off to about 35,000 pop before we start modding. At least. This seems to be working. Yeah, it doesn't seem to be working very well now, does it? This junction's a problem. That junction's a problem, and this whole roundabout is going to be a problem. So next time round, maybe we will try and do something here. Maybe. I don't know. We're not sure. I'm never sure. Saying that, I don't think any streams that you'll ever see me doing on this will ever go the way that we planned them at the very start of the show. But what have we got going on here? This is what we have done over the course of the last 4 hours. We've built up our zoo. We've built up a nature reserve. We've built up this entire area. We've got an abandoned building there. Why is it abandoned? What's so wrong? No, not the... Show me the building. Organic food market abandoned. Worker education was too low. We're going to have to work on that. We have got a high school here somewhere now, haven't we? There's the community school. Where's the high school? Did we not put a high school in? Are people not walking up from Lake Park where there is quite a lot of adults? And I bet the education's very good as well.
Are they not coming to work at the organic food shop? Anyway, what were we talking about? Yes, we've built up Woodland Park, Lake Park, Birdsong Park, still sort of languishing in its own eco hell. We've got our farming district. We've started to introduce some of the new buildings from Harbours, Sunset Harbours DLC, and we continue to not be an educational institution of repute. We've got to get the students in. So we need to make sure next time around that all of our buildings and all of our residential districts are busy making babies. So we may have to call the next episode Teaching Them the Birds and the Bees. But what you should do now is go and find yourself a better streamer. Just search on Twitch. It's not that hard. Go find Cringer. That's where we're going to next. We'll drop him the host at the end of the stream. Until next time we meet, possibly, quite possibly, at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, unless I'm coughing like a stormtrooper, in which case I'll be in self-isolation with a crate of wine and an unlimited supply of pizzas from the local pizza place. But wherever you're going on to now, do have yourself a great afternoon, evening, or night, and we'll catch up with you next time around. From me, Slow Psycho, follow me. Subscribe on YouTube at slowpsycho.tv/YouTube. I won't say drop me a sub here, because it's not worth it. Save your money for the impending Armageddon. Bye-bye.